y'all, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you how to make two super cute bee-themed crafts that you can use for your tiered trays or just anywhere you need a little decoration. All right, friends, let us get started. What do I have here? I have some of these little mini wooden scoops. These came from Hobby Lobby, and I got them for $1.99. Actually, they were on sale, so I didn't pay the full $1.99, but these are in the store over with, as you can see here, it says party, over with the party supplies. That's where I found these. In my store, they were on an end cap, okay? With like all little miniature buckets and things like that. So if you can't find them on the shelf, look at the end caps. So I have a package of these, and we're just gonna rip them open. Let's see, let's use this one right here. Right here. Now, because we're gonna be like running some twine through here, as you can see, this doesn't have a hole in it. So we're gonna have to make a hole in it with my trusty Hoto Tools drill here. So for stability, because this part is really, really flat, I'm gonna lay that flat side down. And first, let's decide where we wanna put the hole. Get my trusty pencil over here. I got my Christmas pencil because I'm sick and tired of this daggone heat. And I'm just going to draw a little dot right there, kind of in the center, because that's where I want this hole to be. And then I'm just going to drill a hole. I'm going to have to stand up for this, but as you can see, I'm just going to drill it straight through the handle. Okay, now you can paint this if you want. I'm not going to paint it. I'm just going to leave it just like that in its natural state. I like that color. I think it'll work out just fine. But now I have this pack of beads here. These are bee-themed beads. You can see right there, they have like little bees. That one has some beads and some dots and some stripes. And then you also have some solid ones. I'm going to have a link for you down in the description box. I'll also pin a comment as to where I got these. I got them on Amazon. And as you can see, they come with their own twine. So that's kind of cool. Oh, now I'm going to have to cut this bag. Y'all know me with beads. Watch me. I'm going to spill them everywhere and I'm going to make a daggum mess. That's what I'm going to do. Ooh, I did it. Not yet. Give me time. But anyway, let's just open up this twine here like so. Just find the end. Aha. Now, I don't know exactly how long I want this to be. Let's see. So I'm going to count that much probably is going to be sticking out of the end when I tie it. And let's see, I want this to be a good length because this is going to be something that you can hang off of something on your tiered tray. I've seen people make these and then you know, you have like your little cookie jars or just little decorative jars and they hang them from those. You know, whatever you want to do with it. It's just a thing. So many people ask me, well, what do you do with it? Okay, it's a decoration. It's just a decoration. You know, that's what it is. All right, so now we have our twine and I've just folded, I was going to say bent it in half. We just folded it in half and now I'm going to thread it through this hole right here. Okay, so I'm going to show you how I thread twine through holes. Woo! Ric Flair, woo! How I thread it through holes like so. Because this hole is kind of small. I didn't want to drill it really big. Because the bigger you make the hole, you know, the more fragile it is around the edge of your little scoop here. So I took a piece of floral wire. Can you see that? Then I just put the floral wire through the end like so. And then I just bent it. And then I'm just going to use that to thread it through like so. Okay, just take your wire off and there you are. Okay, let's take this and you see fingers through the loop and then I just grab it and pull it through and then we'll tighten it down like so. That looks good, just like that. And now you can thread your beads on it. Now I don't know which order I want my beads, my BB beads to be on here. So I'm just gonna lay those out. So you can see they're pretty cute. I really like these. We look at that one. How adorable is that? But anyway, let me thread some of these on. I spilled the beads. All right. So this is what I have. You know what? Let's just tie it this way. I'm going to tie it this way just to make a knot so that our beads don't come flying off, okay? Our BB beads would be flying. All right, let's make another one. Let's do one more. All right, you can leave it like that, but for me, I'm going to tie a loop. Okay, I had to hold it down in my lap. It's a lot of times it's just so hard to do so that I'm reaching my arms across the table, you know, and it's just easier for me to hold it in my lap. Now you can have this to hang it on something. But like I said, a lot of people use it like with their decorative jars. You know, they take the lid off the jar and then you have a big loop that you can put, you know, around your jar and then you put the lid back on. I've seen a lot of people do that. But I'm just going to leave it like that. All right, so now what are we going to put here? This is lightweight spackle. You see how lightweight this is? When you pick up the container, it's going to feel awfully light for the size of the container. My container's got glitter all over it over here. Because I used this like for Christmas time last year. But this is the fast and final. You want the lightweight spackle. It's going to say 30-minute paint ready. Okay. 30 minutes. Now the other kind, when you pick up the container, it's going to feel very heavy. That's the wrong kind. You have got to have the lightweight spackle. If you use the heavy kind, it's not going to hold its shape. It's going to ooze everywhere. It doesn't dry very quickly, and it's just not going to give you the result that you want. So I have my plastic spoon here, and I'm just stirring this up. Because like I said, I haven't used it for a while. I just need to stir it. And you see how like light, I sound like Willy Wonka, light. And frothy. You see how light that looks? It looks kind of like frosting. That's the kind that you want. Now, usually I would use a piping bag for this, but I'm only going to be using a small amount, and I don't want to waste a piping bag for that. So I'm going to just use a Ziploc bag. Just cut the corner off, and I'm going to be using this piping tip. This is a 1M from Wilton. Let's just put this in our bag here. Be careful that the little ends don't poke your bag. All right. Now, Ziploc bags are a lot more fragile than the piping bags, so just be really careful when you're piping this stuff out, okay? I'm just gonna glop some down in there. That should be plenty, but I'm just gonna put another one in there because the next craft that I'm doing, I'm also gonna be using this, okay? So let's just get it down in there. Just kind of squish it down towards the end. I'm going to have to hold this tip in place, okay? Now let's kind of put something on either side to hold this so that it'll be stable. Lord knows I'm not stable, but we need to stabilize our craft. So now we're just going to take this and I'm just going to pipe it in there to look like whipped cream, frosting, whatever you may would be baking. Just pipe that in there like so. Just pull it straight up like that. There we go. That's the look I'm going for. Now I can move this. Now I want to drizzle something on here to sort of look like honey. So what I'm going to be using for that is this gallery glass. A lot of people have been saying that they can't find, you know, in previous videos when I do bee crafts, I like to use yellow hot glue sticks for the honey. It all depends on what you're making. But you can also use this, and I have used this, gallery glass. This is a color light yellow. This is the paint that you use for like the faux stained glass. If you do that, you know what I'm talking about. Now you can get this in Hobby Lobby. Look over in the section where they have things for stained glass, or you can get this on Amazon. Again, look down in the description box in the comments and I will have a link for you to where you can get it. And now I'm just gonna squeeze it on here. You know, just to look like a honey drizzle type thing. Just like so. It pooped. Let's put some here. Okay. It looks better when it dries, believe me. Okay, now I'm going to put a little bee on here. And I have these little bees. Once again, from Amazon, I'll link to those for you. And you get several different sizes of these bees, which is pretty cool. Let's see, I think they have a bigger one. These, I don't know, a few different sizes. Oh, here's like the granddaddy bee here. All right. Oh, I just threw him in the floor. I'm back, I rescued him. Trying to decide which size I want. And I think this great big one will be fine. And I'm just going to, just going to plop him down and just kind of press him down, stupid gnats, like so, just right like that. And I might put a smaller one over here. And then we're just going to let this sit up and dry, okay? This is going to take a little bit to dry. Just leave it alone. And I want to see if I can find some ribbon. I will add a bow up here. But anyway, let's just leave this alone for a little bit. This has been sitting here for a while. Now, this paint here takes about 24 hours to dry, so this paint has not totally dried. But this tiny little bow that I made, I am going to glue that down, and then I'm just going to push it off to the side and let it set up just a little bit more. Actually, quite a bit more. It's only been like an hour or so. But anyway, let's just get this little bow on here, and then I'll just push it over there and let it sit. And now we're going to move on to the next one. Moving along, look at this little spoon. Is this not cute? It is so cute. And I got it off of Amazon. Again, look in the description box and comments. I'm going to have links for a lot of this stuff. So anyway, this cute little spoon. And we're going to be doing this spoon just like we did the scoop. Because I like the way they look. They're so, so, so cute. I lost my pencil. Where's my pencil? Somebody help me. All right. We're going to do the same thing that we did with our scoop. Because this doesn't have, let's see, let's go right about here with it. I have a hole. Don't watch me. I will probably drill a hole through my table. This table, bless its heart, has been with me for a long time. There we go. Just pulse it all through. Pull it out. All right. Now I can put my drill away. Let's sit over here. And now we're going to do the same thing with this spoon that we did for our scoop over there. So where did my, right here, my twine, and just however long that you want to make this, okay? I might make this one just a little bit longer. I don't know. I don't know. Let's put it right about there. Should be good. Like I said, it depends on what you're going to do with this, you know, if you're going to just use it like just as a garland to drape, or if you want to hang it up for a little ornament, whatever you want to do. All right, so I have my piece of floral wire here. Now let's find the center of our twine. Just going to thread that through. Yes, I could have made the hole bigger, but like I said previously, I'm trying to hang on to the integrity of our pieces that we're working on. You know, in case you have cats, dogs, and feral children running around that might get a hold of this, they won't grab the beads and like yank it or something and then break the end off of your scoop or spoon. Okay. There we go. There's that. And now we're just going to thread on the beads. These cute little bee beads that I used a while ago for our scoop. We're going to be using those again for this. I might try to jazz up the order that I put the beads on the other one so they aren't identical. I mean, you know, same concept. You know, I'm just showing you two different ways to do it. So let's just take my twine here. Oh, that one's, look, crooked. That's about as crooked as a politician. You see that? I'm going to have to trim the ends on that. But anyway, I just thread it through my wire and then decide which beads I want to use. And I'm just going to start threading them on. Okay, so I made this one just a little bit longer. I think I might put a tassel on the end of this one. I'm just going to, once again, let's just tie it twice. Okay, and I'm going to get a piece of cardboard and a roll of twine here. And let's make a tassel. Okay. So I have this piece of cardboard, just decided about how long I wanted the tassel to be, and that's how long I cut my cardboard. Now let's just cut off a piece of twine here that we're going to use here just in a moment to tie around it. But now you're just going to find the end here, and let's put that down right like so. Now I'm just going to wrap it. I don't know how many times I'm going to wrap this. A handful. Just a handful. I will do that. And then we're going to attach it to the end of our beads here. Okay, I'm done wrapping it. So then let's just slide this off the cardboard here. And I'm trying to be so careful to keep the center because this is the center. And now let's thread this through there. Where did it go? There we go. All right, just thread that through. Okay, let's try to keep that right so. And now I'm just going to tie a knot. Trying to be so careful to keep it where it needs to be. Where it needs to be. Shut up. All right. Let's pull this down this way. I think that looks okay. All right. Now I'm just going to go through and cut that. And we can fix the ends here in a second. Okay. Now I'm just going to take this piece of twine and lay it down, and then I'm just going to tie a knot. Okay, so there is that, and I'm going to work with this here just in a little bit to get that straightened out just a little bit more. But anyway, now what we're going to do, just like we did with our little scoop, we're going to add on this Fast and Final lightweight spackle. And as you saw a while ago, I already have it in my bag here with my Ziploc bag that's getting ready to explode. And I'm just going to put a big blob right there in the center. Whee! Okay, once again, I've got this stuff all over me. My goodness. Anyway, going back in with our gallery glass that we used a while ago. And just putting some on here just to look like honey. Like that, and like that, and like that, and like that, and again like that. Okay. Now, why is this lid not going on? User error. And now I might, do I want to use a different bee? No, I'm going to use the same little bees that I used on our scoop. And you know, I had some bees that I had gotten at Hobby Lobby. I think I'm just going to use these on this one. Let's see what size I want to use. I think I'm just going to do one. Yeah, I think I'm just going to do one on this one. Let's just plop him down. I'm trying to not smear everything. Just plop him down right in the center. There we go. That bee just landed in the whipped cream. Whatever we're making here, he just landed in it. Okay, stupid gnat. Don't you just love the hot weather and you have the windows open and then all the little things come in because you live beside a cow pasture? But anyway, now we are pretty much done with that. All right, so this tiny little bow here, I'm just going to glue this on right here. Which way do I want to put it? Do I want it? I say about right there, I think. Okay. I was trying to think, do I want to put it down further? Do I want to put it like right up here? I think right there in the center of the handle is just fine with me. All right. Now that is that. Both of these are done. And y'all saw it at the beginning of the video, but stick around to the end of the video and you'll see another picture of it. But I hope that you liked this. If you would, please give this video a thumbs up. Click subscribe. Check me out on other forms of social media, the links to all of which will be in the description box down below. And I will see y'all next time. Bye.